So what we're looking at in this video is cropping an image. We've already seen that if you rotate an image arbitrarily, you'll end up with lots of information that you don't want in the image, these large white areas that we can see. So that's one reason to crop your image. Another reason might be to concentrate on a certain section of the image, or you may wish to crop it to apply the rule of thirds or something along that line. Okay? As we'll see later, one thing that you do need to remember with cropping is that you will be throwing away all of the pixels that you are removing. Problem with doing that to a digital image is that it is made up of miniature little squares, pixels, that can be only one tone of one colour. So as you remove pixels, as you get rid of them or change them, it can have negative impact on the quality of the image and also the size that you can print it out to. For now, we're just going to look at cropping to get rid of these white areas and give our image back 90 degree corners. The crop tool is 5 tools down on the options on the toolbox, rather, if you have it in the elongated state. And as soon as you've selected it by left clicking, you get the option toolbar for the crop tool. We'll look at this in more detail later on, but for now, all we're needing to do is drop a crop box. To do this, we position the mouse cursor in the corner we want to start. I always go from the top left-hand corner myself. Press and hold the left mouse button once the tool is in position, and then draw out our marching ants line. Once you're reasonably happy with the crop box, if we release the left mouse button, everything outside of the crop area is in grey. Everything inside retains the proper colour. As you can see from my box, I've still got some little bits of white in the area. And here we can make use of the handles on the four corners and the midpoints of the middle and of the horizontal and vertical lines making up the box. To use a handle, we position the mouse cursor over the top of that handle, press and hold the left mouse button, and resize the crop box. As I was saying, we want to retain as much information as we can in the image, so it's always a good idea to start with to try and keep as much information as possible. Once you're happy with your box, you have two buttons on the options toolbar. The circle with a line through it is the cancel current crop operation. So you could click that and it would undo your crop box, or alternatively you can press escape and it gets rid of that. We also have the green tick, if I just get this back into position. And the green tick is the confirm the crop operation. You can also do this with pressing enter on the keyboard or double clicking inside the crop area. Once you're happy, click on the tick and it will apply the crop, and that's it. And then you can save the image. And remember, you don't ever want to save over the original image in most instances, but here we have done a number of actions to the image, so we should have a duplicate that we're saving to. As I say, as you crop, do be aware that you're losing pixels. If I use the zoom tool, the little magnifying glass towards the bottom of the toolbox, I can zoom in. I'm going to zoom in on the red car. Scroll down a little bit. can see already that we're starting to get to pixelation. If I keep on doing little squares, it's because I'm on an Apple Mac, it's showing me the pixels. Okay, we can get full screen again by clicking on full screen. It's not quite the one I wanted. It's full screen. So do be aware, if you crop too much, you will start to get pixelation depending on how big you view the image. Give you a quick demo of that. If we crop just for the word Sainsbury's, and the image is now relatively tiny, if I command O, and you can see we've got very obvious pixelation of that word. So if I tried to print this out, it would look awful, I think. So if I edit and step backwards, or edit and undo. So there's our image cropped to retain or get back those 90 degree angles on the corners and lose all of that empty white space. A second reason that you might want to crop, like I say, is to get rid of extraneous detail, areas in the image that don't add to it in any way. So if I just rotate this image, so you've got all of these trees and the foreground that we don't necessarily need. So if I want to crop to get rid of those bits, and you can physically see I've made the image that much smaller. And if we zoom in, see how big it is. Oh, make it full screen rather. Okay, resolution is something that we'll deal with separately. What we're looking at here is cropping. So to crop an image, if I open a new one at random, I'm going to go for the apple. To crop an image, all we have to do is position the mouse cursor. Like I say, I always start on the top left hand side, press and hold the left mouse button, draw out our crop box, release the left mouse button, and then resize as required. And then confirm our crop. That's cropping with Photoshop.